let's take a look at the relationship between hypothesis tests and confidence intervals. I'm going to discuss this in the context of inference for one mean, but the same relationship holds in many other situations as well. Suppose we find a 1 minus alpha times 100% confidence interval for mu using this formula, which would be appropriate if we were sampling from a normally distributed population where sigma is known. And suppose we wish to carry out a test of the null hypothesis that mu is equal to mu naught against a two-sided alternative at a significance level of alpha. Well, we would typically go ahead and use our Z test statistic, come up with a p-value, and draw a conclusion. But I could tell you what that conclusion would be by looking at the confidence interval, because there is a relationship between confidence intervals and hypothesis tests. Suppose we are using the same value of alpha in these two spots. So suppose alpha is 0.05 here, and up here we are using a 95% confidence interval. So the alpha level is the same in both spots. And we are using a two-sided alternative. Then there is a direct relationship between hypothesis tests and confidence intervals. The confidence interval will be made up of all values of mu naught for which we would not reject the null hypothesis. Let's look at a couple of examples to illustrate. Suppose a 90% confidence interval for mu is found to be 13.1 to 26.4. What would be the results of a test of the null hypothesis that mu is equal to 25 against a two-sided alternative at an alpha level of 0.1? A 90% confidence interval corresponds to an alpha level of 10%, or 0.10, and so our two alpha levels are the same here, and the alternative hypothesis is two-sided, so there is a direct relationship between the confidence interval and the hypothesis test. The hypothesized value of 25 falls within this interval, and so we would not reject the null hypothesis at an alpha level of 0.1. Loosely speaking, 25 is a plausible value of mu. And since we would not reject the null hypothesis at a significance level of 0.1, we know that the p-value would be greater than 0.1. Suppose a 95% confidence interval for mu is found to be 48.2 to 87.6. What would be the results of a test of the null hypothesis that mu is equal to 40 against a two-sided alternative at an alpha level of 0.05? A 95% confidence interval corresponds to an alpha level of 5%, or 0.05. And so the alpha level for the confidence interval and the hypothesis test are the same, and the hypothesis test has a two-sided alternative. So that direct relationship between hypothesis tests and confidence intervals holds here as well. The hypothesized value of 40 falls outside of this 95% confidence interval. And so we know that if we were to carry out the hypothesis test, we would reject the null hypothesis at an alpha level of 0.05, which would mean the p-value of the test is less than 0.05. Why is this the case? Well, we would reject the null hypothesis at an alpha level of 0.05 if the test statistic takes on a value less than or equal to -1.96 or greater than or equal to 1.96. This is the Z test statistic. And using a little algebra to isolate mu naught, we would reject the null hypothesis if the hypothesized value of mu is greater than or equal to x bar plus 1.96 sigma over the square root of n, or the hypothesized value mu naught is less than or equal to x bar minus 1.96 times sigma over the square root of n. But this is the upper bound of a 95% confidence interval for mu, and this is a lower bound of a 95% confidence interval for mu. And so if the hypothesized value falls outside of the confidence interval, we would reject the null hypothesis. But if it falls within the confidence interval, we would not reject the null hypothesis. Here I've described the relationship between confidence intervals and hypothesis tests in the context of inference for one mean, but this relationship holds in many other statistical inference scenarios as well. Note that confidence intervals are important in their own right, and not simply for their relationship to hypothesis tests. Confidence intervals give a range of plausible values for a parameter, and are very useful in interpreting the results of a study.